Oh, you smell good today. YouTube video. Today is day 25 of the Project 30 challenge. Again, the challenge where I upload 30 YouTube videos in 30 days. If you guys are new here, make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel, turn on post notifications, because we got 5 videos left, gang. And again, I have to say this too, we just broke 2500 subs. So for all my people who are new here, you've never seen any of these previous videos, make sure you click on the Project 30 playlist and just breeze through some of the videos so you can get a good understanding of what I'm doing and why I am doing it. Today's video is going to be a spinoff of what I just posted. I just gave you guys a full in-gym workout vlog so I can better show you guys how I train physically. But today I want to give you guys a full basketball workout video, because a lot of you guys actually asked me a lot of questions about like my athletic background, but I never gave you guys actual insight on why I still continue to train as an athlete. So I figured, why not take you guys through a basketball workout, give you guys that information about who I am athletically and why I started hooping and so on and so forth. So I'm here in Torrance. We're at Shoot 360, the gym I took you guys to earlier in this challenge. And I want to take you guys through a quick basketball workout. I only have an hour. I can only pay for an hour session. So real quick, get my jump shots up, explain to you guys what I do and why I do it and where my basketball athleticness came from, and let's get right into it. As far as my basketball career goes, I played basketball my entire life from when I was a child all the way up through high school. I watched my dad play back. Like when I was younger, I didn't idolize anybody else. I didn't idolize superstars. I didn't idolize NBA players. My dad was like my idol as far as basketball came, because I watched him play everywhere. He played in the parks. He played in the leagues. He played in every gym. Every place we walked into when basketball was involved, people knew my dad as that dude on the court. So like, my dad was my basketball influence growing up. So like, I continue to play basketball just because it's always been instilled with me. I did play football in college, but that was because I got to college playing football. Like, I'm a smaller stature guy, so me playing basketball at the next level wasn't something that was of interest to me. My dad let me know that early on. So after I finished playing college ball, like I got right back into hooping again. Like, not consistently, but I would go through spurts of like, you know, months on end where I'd hoop every day, then I take a break because I get hurt or I'm tired or I'm still weightlifting. So like, I don't want to lose too much muscle from running around and hooping every single day. But now that I'm at the age where like, I want to be as athletic and I don't want to be as big and bulky, basketball has definitely attributed to like me staying in shape.
So what's really dope about this gym is you can actually set up a free shoot and you can select areas around the court where you just want to shoot shots at. So for first, I'm gonna shoot free throws. So you can adjust where you want the ball to be passed out to you, and it'll pass right to you. It's super, like growing up, I wish I had this type of facility or this type of training accessibility when I was a kid. First shot of the day. Oh, it's gonna be a long day. It's gonna be a long day. And again, when I was growing up, I was never known as someone who shoots jump shots on a regular basis. So like, me having the ability to like work on my shot now is like, it's huge for me. Basketball has always been my first love. Like, that was my very first athletic love growing up. Like, I'm a Bulls fan. You guys know I'm a Mike fan. Michael Jordan is my GOAT. So like, playing basketball was like, that was like the first love of my life, if I'm being honest with you. I know y'all see the full Anaka fit on, right? I got the full fit on. I got the shirt and the shorts on. You're lucky I don't got the socks on too. Hey. So the next drill I set up is a mid-range side to side. So one side to left side, and the ball will get passed to me as I rotate back. So I'll shoot one, it'll rotate, pass, shoot again. All right, let's get started. Oof. Get set. I love having the ability to work on things that I'm not good at, which shooting was definitely one of them for me growing up. Just cause I had so many people trying to change my jump shot when I was younger. No one really gave me the confidence to just shoot the ball and then learn the proper way to shoot it after I know how to shoot, or after I'm confident enough to shoot, you know? So now, being older, I have the ability and the finances to want to want to work on my jumper, which is nice for me. All right, so now we're just going top of the key, three ball switch. I try to get at least 25 to 30 into these. But again, this is my weakest. my weakest point of playing basketball is this range. So repetition is super important for me. There we go. Oh, you feel good today. So, halftime, give myself a little 5-minute break. Take the shirt off, obviously. I just noticed too that I ain't got a haircut this whole challenge. I don't think so, at least. So, I'm long overdue for a cut. I might get a cut sometime this weekend. Cause, look, bro. Yeah, I'm looking like a whole bum right now. All right, so I'm actually not supposed to show you guys this, but I am going anyway. So this screen right here that you guys see, that is a percentage keeper and like a shot tracker. So what it does, it essentially tracks the trajectory of where your shots are coming from and allows you to see if you're shooting far off to the left, far off to the right. It keeps the percentage based off of where you're shooting from. So the top of the key right now, I'm shooting 24 for 51 from the 3-point line, which is close to 50%. My mid-range, I was shooting 15 for 30 on my left side and 18 for 30 on my right side. And then my free throws, I went 32 for 51. So that's dope. When it comes to like trying to get better at something, and as important as reps are, if you're able to track stats to see where your weak points are, where your strong points are, and what you can get better at, or what to work on more, this is a place that will allow you to actually train to get better, and not just train because, you know, Instagram training is dope right now. To be in the gym doing da-da-da-da, like that's dope, that's cool. But like, when you're really trying to work on something, whatever sport it is, whatever hobby or skill set it is, I take this back to even content creation. Working on videos, your output is just as important as how much you're actually trying to work on your craft. Because if you're constantly putting videos out, you have evidence of when you're gonna get better. You have evidence of what videos do well, what videos don't do well. You can see your progress from one video to the next, to the next, to the next. When you go back and look down, like after this challenge is over with, I can go back and look at video number 1 and 2 and 3 and see like, okay, I like what I did here, but I don't like the fact that this looks like this. Or I can shorten these clips up. These are all B-roll filler clips. So I love this gym. This is a perfect opportunity for me to talk about working on a craft. And this stems far, look, I just read a quote right here that's in the building. You can't see it because it's through the net. But it says, repetition is the key to learning. That is the God honest truth. Repetition is the honest key to learning and getting better at anything. That's 5. That's 6. That's off. That's 7. One more. Come on. Come on now. That's 8. Yes, sir. All right, so for this, I actually have to crank this downwards so I can increase the height so the ball comes out higher, because I'm gonna step back a little bit so I can get my off the dribble hezzy jump shots in. I think it's this way. So I know I should probably work on other off the dribble moves, but the hezzy pull up is just like, that's the only dribble move I like, because I can come off hezzy and go by, or I can come off and cross, and I can do it this way too, but that's the only dribble move I know and I like to do. So that's what I'm gonna do. So boom, boom. That's 1. I got a 1-second delay on here too. That's 2. Oh, that's off. Damn it. All right. We're going right side now. I think the important part for me is making sure I get the ball in my pocket, because I'm a right-hand shooter. It's like, there we go. Keeping it in my pocket when I shoot. I felt off too. Hey. There we go. Damn. Get in there. Hey. That felt good too. All right, so currently I'm shooting 58% from the 3. I finish this off by just doing like freestyle moves. So I'll do like a tween, 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 and just moves that I probably wouldn't do with a defender in me. But I do them because it'll allow me to try it and attempt it in game if I ever feel like I want to. So I just freestyle it like. Hey. That was good too. Oof. Good shot, boy. Oh! Hey. Get in there, Dave. Yeah. All right, let's finish off with free throws. Just quick, no form, no warm up, just catch all form shots. I try to go at least 10 for 10, then I stop. That's five. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Oh, I ran out of time. Anyways, that's all good. Finish up. So that is it for day 25 of the Project 30 Challenge. I'll try to put the basketball workout in the description, so all my hoopers who watch this, if you wanna try it, go ahead. I know y'all probably got a routine, but it's just another workout to do. So thank y'all again for tapping in. I'll catch you guys tomorrow. It's your boy. And I'm tired, but I'm gone. Whew.